I managed to install stable diffusion on my local server, and it's working just fine. Text to image, image to image, extras, train, settings, extensions. These are some of the features which I will explore in a separate episode. In this one, I want to show you how to install stable diffusion locally with minimal effort. However, you have to follow the exact steps that I provide you. Initially, I did run into some errors which had something to do with Torch and Python version. That's why, do not install any other version, just follow the exact steps and you should be fine. Also note, I'm on a NVIDIA 2070 Super GPU. So if you're running on any other graphics card which doesn't support stable diffusion, then you might run into some errors. In that case, maybe put it in the comments and I'll see if I can provide a fix. Keeping everything aside, running on Windows, ladies and gents, this is how you install stable diffusion locally. First, you'll have to install a few software. Git, Python 3.10.6, GFPGAN v1.4, SD v1.4. The last one is a 4 GB, pretty huge, so it might take you a while to download it. To get the first one, git for windows.org, simply download and install it on your local server. Second, we'll download Python. Make sure you download 3.10.6. This version seems to be the only one that's working with what I'm about to show you. Then we have GFPGAN and SDV1.4. For GFPGAN, head over to GitHub and keep scrolling down until you see add V1.4 model. There's another one, 1.3, and several others. Just ignore them. Simply install V1.4. Next, head over to huggingface.co and download SD version 1.4.ckpt. Like I said earlier, this is a bigger file, so it'll take you a while to download it. Alright, so now we have all the files we need. Install Git the way you would do. Keep everything default. Since I've already installed Python, when you are installing for the first time, you'll probably only see two options. The second one, which has a path, make sure it has a tick on it. And once that's done, now get on your Windows program and open Git. It's either Git bash or Git. It'll take you to this command prompt. We'll pause here for a second. Head over to your local C drive. Your local C drive and Windows. Create a folder, call it AI or whatever you want to name it. Right now you can see there's stable diffusion. Initially it wouldn't be there. You'll have to clone it, which I'm showing you in a second. So simply create a folder on Windows, your local drive, call it AI. Open git bash, type cd, which is change directory, c:// hit enter, then cd space AI, enter, and you can see right now we are in C drive and AI folder. This is where we'll be cloning stable diffusion. Now type git clone space, head over to this website, click on code, https, copy this, go back to the git terminal. If you right click your mouse, it should paste the link. Now simply hit enter and it should start cloning. Now you'll see this entire folder, stable diffusion, and this entire thing will start building. It may take some time. So once you're done, now simply head over because we will be moving two more files. Remember GFPGAN and SD? GFPGAN, move this file, drag it to stable diffusion web UI, as you can see right here. Now next, go to models, go to stable diffusion, move SD version 1.4, right here. You can see I've done it. And that's it. Once you're done with this, the final step, now simply open web UI.user, and this is how it should look like. This will run stable diffusion, and now you can go and type whatever you want to see and generate if it works. All right, ladies and gents, that's your tiger in a lake. I hope you found this useful. It's a very straight up, straight to the point guide. If you run into any kind of error that says Python issues, you may have to uninstall Python, clean up, and then reinstall everything. And if still that doesn't work, delete stable diffusion web UI, open git, follow the method git clone paste the URL, and do it all over again, and it should work. Ladies and gents, thanks for watching. Elite System, over and out.